Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at using the Finder to compress video and audio. So this is something fairly new to Mac OS X, and it makes a common task much easier. You can select either audio or video file. Let's start with a video file here. And you can control click or right click or two finger click, depending upon your device, on it. I'm going to control click and get the context menu. One of the options in the context menu is encode selected video files. When you select that, you'll get a little dialog that gives you some options. And here it comes. And you get some basic encoding options. Nothing too special. Pretty much what you get inside of the QuickTime Player, but you don't have to run QuickTime Player to use it. And you can recompress this video. You can do it at 480p, for instance, to make it smaller. You can just say audio only, because I just want the audio from the video. And you can encode it either for a lot of compatibility or greater quality. So let's make it very compatible at 840. And then I can select where to save it, or just say same as the source. I can even say delete the source. So I just want to compress it and get rid of the original. Hit continue, and what will happen is it'll take a little bit of time, and you'll see the new one appear there, and that's going to be an M4V file. And if I select it, you can see the original is 2.9 megs, and the new version is going to be smaller. It's going to be 5.2 megs. And either one will look very similar, but this one will be a lot smaller to use. Very handy if you've taken some video with your iPhone or camera and it's a big high-def video and you just want to quickly compress it to share it with somebody. Now likewise, we can do the same with an audio file. So we're going to take, in this case, an MP3 file. If I control click on it, and it will say encode selected audio files, and I get a slightly different set of options. I can set the quality for it here, and the lowest quality would be a spoken podcast. So I can compress it and save it back out. Now I can do the same for some audio files. So let's select this WAV file, for instance, here. And I'm going to recompress it into something a little more compatible and it's a little smaller size. I can control click and code selected audio files. And now it gives me several options here. I'll stick with high quality in this case. Hit continue and I get an M4A file. It's a little more compatible than the WAV file there. And I can see that it is smaller too, only 20K as opposed to 86. It's a short file, but you can imagine a longer piece of audio will get a lot more benefit out of that compression. And you can go to this original file here, and let's control click on it and encode the video files, and let's select that we want it to go audio only. And now we continue and we'll actually get an M4A file, an audio file that's just the audio from that video. So one word of warning, this doesn't always work. It has to be a certain file format to begin with. So sometimes you get a file, say like an MP3 file, and you try to compress it, it won't do it. Usually when this happens, it's because the file is already in a good compressed format. So for instance, taking a WAV file or an AIF file in audio and using this will work, but taking an MP3 usually doesn't work and usually don't need it. So there's not much more to it than that. It's pretty simple. You don't get very many options, but it's a handy way to be able to recompress audio and video if you want to send somebody a copy or just archive it yourself, not at the full quality. You get some more options if you're using QuickTime Player, and then of course there's tons of apps out there that'll do complex conversions. You can always use iMovie and Final Cut Pro to do it as well. But this is a very simple tool you can use in the Finder without using any other apps. Hope you found this useful. Until next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.